got more now on the preparations for Tropical Depression Harvey.
That's right. Folks are right now lining up to get free sandbags being handed out by the city of Corpus Christi. This is happening on Civitan Drive near Holly and Ayers. There's a city yard there, and that's where our Bill Churchwell is at the moment, live to tell us how it's going. There, Bill.
Hey guys, yeah, I have to tell you that I'm standing at what was that large pile of sand, that free sand that was being given away. In less than an hour, it is now gone. The city plans to bring more sand tomorrow morning starting at 8 a.m. They are assessing the situation, but you can see some folks are still trying to get the last little bit of sand right here, and they are filling up these free bags that are being provided by the city right now. For folks who have concerns about flooding in their neighborhoods or at their business. And tell me your name.
Marissa Lopez.
And tell us about why you decided to come out here.
Where I live at, it's flooded two previous times, so we just want to take all precautions possible.
Does it usually flood out there pretty high?
Yes, it does, about up knee high.
What are your concerns for this approaching storm?
I'm just trying to take as many precautions possible. I don't want anything to happen. Stocked up on water, trying to get as much sand as possible to cover the doors.
Trying to get as much sand as possible, and you're scooping up the last little bit here. How did you feel about the sand going so fast?
I thought there would be more, but they said it'll be available tomorrow, so I'm going to come first thing to try to get more.
And you are not the only one looking for sand this evening. When we got here, there was a long line of cars stretched down the street looking for sand as well. And you can see many of those cars still along the stretch of road. They are now being turned away. But again, the city is assessing the situation, and they are looking at bringing in more sand possibly tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. Reporting live, Bill Churchwell. 3 News.
3 News reporter Bill Churchwell standing outside the studio right now with a live look also at what we see from our perspective from the station across over to the freeway behind him. Bill, how's it going? Still very windy.
Hey there, Rudy. Yeah, I can not only tell you what we are seeing, but I can tell you what we are feeling. These hurricane force winds are not letting up. I thought they were dying out a little bit earlier, but then we would get another strong gust like we are right now. These gusts are very intense. I want to say gusting well over 60, 70 miles per hour. Still, we are dealing with these very strong winds. You can see the trees just waving in the wind right now. We're also hearing a lot of, actually, there's a car going down SPID right now, which of course you should not be out in this. It is just not safe to be driving in these conditions. You heard in that last live report, there is just so much debris out here right now, right here in Corpus Christi. You know, it could be leaves on the ground, or it could be branches on the ground, but it could also be power lines, and that can be very dangerous, especially if you're driving over that mess. And earlier we actually found a board with nails that blew in our way. And so you just want to be careful. If you're at home, hunker down, stay there. You don't need to be out driving in this, trying to look around yourself. Also, with those down power lines, we're getting a lot of power reports, power outages. So you definitely want to be aware of that. And it's interesting because across the street we have several businesses. You can see power on at some of them, and whether that's because of a backup generator or whatever. But we're also hearing a lot of metal banging, and so I don't know if that's another one of those very strong wind gusts that we're getting right now, and they're periodic out here. The winds will calm down a bit, and then they'll get stronger again and want to blow you over. But you know, where we are at right now, we're not venturing too far off. We have the overhang here, which is helping protect us, and we're right outside of our door of the station. If we need to jump in, we're going to do that as well. As far as the rain, not really seeing much rain right now, but the wind remains intense, and that's really what we are feeling out here currently. Rudy, back to you. Folks began lining up here at this checkpoint outside of Port Aransas early this morning for their chance to get a look at their homes for the first time since evacuating before Harvey made landfall. They have hope that everything will be okay, but they also know the magnitude of the situation. They've seen the images on TV, and they know the reality that they might not have a home when they return.
And I got a buddy in there that said, just tell me to be prepared, man.
Miguel Cantu is not looking forward to seeing what lies beyond this police checkpoint.
Stuff they're showing is kind of devastation.
He is one of dozens of folks who are now making the journey back to the coastal community hit hard by Hurricane Harvey.
There's large parts of the town that are missing. You know, they're just missing. They're gone.
Businesses destroyed. Homes leveled by the weight of Harvey's winds. Robert Burgess has seen the images and knows it won't be good.
Flyby they did the Coast Guard. I could just barely see that there's something there, but I don't know what's there. It could just be the garage.
Authorities checking IDs before letting drivers enter the disaster area, making sure those coming in aren't here to take advantage of those who have already lost so much.
Now, folks only had a 6-hour window to go in and view their property, and that's because it's just too dangerous. There's still a lot of debris in Port Aransas. The town just doesn't look the same. And it's also dangerous because there's no utilities, such as power, and there's no telling when power will be restored. Reporting off of Highway 361, Bill Churchwell, 3 News. Rockport, Texas, and the surrounding area, a community trying to rebuild among the debris and destruction here. We came across one woman who is doing her part to help out her fellow neighbors, specifically those who are homebound.
Down almost every street of this coastal community, you will find there is still plenty of raw emotion. Some folks who just need a hug and the reassurance that everything will be okay.
I understand. It's devastating.
Fishing boat captain Billy Koshin is trying to alleviate some of that suffering.
I need 4 hamburgers.
Every day, Koshin has been stopping by makeshift food stands, like this one, to pick up hot meals for those who need them.
To take to some of our senior citizens because they don't have no cars, they can't get out of their home, so I've got to go give them something. Something's better than nothing.
The captain invited us to ride with her as she made personal deliveries to elderly residents in her neighborhood. Despite losing her own home to damage, she found a calling to help others.
I know them senior citizens are used to a routine, and if they get out of the routine, then it's going to make them sick, and that scares me.
Yes.
Her first visit is to 91-year-old Audrey Justice.
I don't know what I'd do without them.
She don't have a car. I mean, she's pretty much on her own, and she's the lady that kind of watches after all of us.
She tells us there are many more elderly residents just like Audrey, especially in the county, who are unable to get out on their own and need a helping hand.
Where's Mama?
Inside.
She's inside?
Yeah.
I got some food for her. I understand their feelings, and I understand the emotions that they're going through, but the only way to get through this is baby steps. And if you let your emotions overrun, then I don't believe that anything's going to get accomplished.
And our fishing boat captain is hoping that others will join her effort to get food, hot food, to those who need it the most. Reporting from Rockport, Bill Churchwell, 3 News.
A warm meal, it makes such a huge difference.
Yeah. And but so many people, I mean, that fishing boat captain, certainly an example, but so many people stepping up, doing whatever they can to help, and that's a good thing. Yeah, that you hate to have a storm to bring that out in folks, but that is a good thing. Bill?
Good job, Captain Billy. Mm-hmm.